Hi students, welcome to maths class. Here I am Venkatesh. Today we will learn an interesting and important topic from 10th class mathematics, that is real numbers. Actually, in our first videos already we have learned about real numbers. In the first video we have learned about logarithms. Then after, in the second video we have learned about real numbers, in that how to determine the HCF and LCM using Euclid division algorithm lemma. Then after we are learned about the theorems. So now we will learn about how to prove that the given number is an irrational number. Before going to the lesson, I will explain about one's basics. So rational number, what is meant by a rational number? A number which can be expressed in the form of P by Q. Here P comma Q are integers. Here reverse case also, if P comma Q are integers, then P by Q is a rational number. Rational number. What is meant by irrational number? A number which cannot be expressed in the form of P by Q, that is called as irrational number. Basically root 2, root 3, root 5 and so on are irrational numbers. Once again, when the number which is not possible to express in the form of P by Q, that is called as irrational number. Here another rule, if A is a prime number, then root A is an irrational number. If A is a prime number, then root A is an irrational number. Next, if A comma B are irrational numbers, then A plus B is irrational number, A minus B is an irrational number, A divided by B is an irrational number, A with multiplication B is also irrational number. Which means if A comma B are irrational numbers, their sum, their subtraction, their division, their product or multiplication is a irrational number. 1.6 explains about if P be a prime number, if P divides A square, then it divides A also. Very important one. If P divides A square, then it divides A also. For example, if P is equal to 2, because 2 is a prime number, A is equal to 6, then A square, what will happen? 36. Once observe, 36 can be divisible by 2, then it divides A also. 6 also divisible by 2. For example, P is equal to 3, A is equal to same, if you take 6, A square is equal to 36. Once observe, 3 divides 36, how many times? 12 times. It divides 6 also, 6 by 3 is equal to 2. Clear with that? If P divides A square, then it divides A also. P divides A square, then it divides A also. Exercise 1.4. The topic what I am explaining now is very very important for your public examinations, because in every time a 4 mark question will come from this exercise 1.4. So that's why listen carefully and practice well. The question is, prove that the following are irrationals. In that, first one is 1 by root. Solution. Let take 1 by root 2 is rational. Already you know root 2 is an irrational number. So then 1 by root 2 is irrational number. But you are assuming that 1 by root 2 is a rational number. Let us see what will happen. If 1 by root 2 is a rational number, then it is possible to express in the form of P by Q. Here P comma Q are integers. Once reverse the fraction, root 2 by 1 is equal to what will happen? Q by P. Here what we said, P and Q are integers. So root 2 is equal to Q by P. Here root 2 actually already you know, root 2 is a irrational number. But from this, what you got, root 2 is an rational number because Q comma P are integers. Actually root 2 is an irrational number, but we got root 2 is an rational number because it is possible to express in the form of Q by P. But we got root 2 is rational, which is a contradiction. Contradiction means both are different, both are not giving the same answers. This statement is different from this statement. Here this is actually it is a irrational number, but that is showing that is a rational number, which is a contradiction. Why you got contradiction? Because our assumption 1 by root 2 is rational is wrong. Therefore, 1 by root 2 is irrational. Hence, it is a proof. Once observe what we are taking, root 2 is a rational number. When you follow the procedure, at some time you got a different answer, which means here it is showing irrational number as a rational number. It is a wrong because root 2 is an irrational number. So the both statements are different. This is a contradiction. Why it is arised? Because our assumption is wrong. What we are taking is wrong. So that's why you are obeying root 1 by root 2 is an irrational number. So in this type, if you are take the statement, what you are taken is as a reverse statement and try to prove, if you got failed means the statement what you are taken is a wrong answer, the statement what is given is a correct one. Now the question is, prove that the following are irrational in that root 5. You have to prove now root 5 is an irrational number. Root 5 is an irrational number. Solution, let us assume like the before sum, root 5 is rational. If it is the rational number, it is possible to express in the form of P by Q. Here P comma Q are integers. P and Q are integers. By cancelling the common factor in P comma Q, we get P by Q is equal to A by B, where A comma B are co-primes. Clear with that? You are taken P by Q are integers, then P by Q is a rational number. You are assumed that root 5 is a rational number. By cancelling the common factor in P and Q, you got the answer P by Q is equal to A by B by cancelling the common factor. So here A comma B are co-primes. Co-primes means it has no common factor in between, only it has a common factor, that is 1. So now express it is root 5 is equal to a by b, a is equal to root 5 into b. By squaring on both sides, what you get? A square is equal to root 5 into b whole square, which gives a square is equal to 5 into b square. Here once observe, a square is equal to 5 into b square, which means if you transpose it to this side, here 5 divides a square. So for example, what I said before, 36 divides by 2, I said, which means 36 is possible to express as 2 into something, that is 13. If you write like this, means here 2 divides 36. Here also same, a square is divided by 5, which means a square by 5 is equal to gives answer b. That's why here is gain from this 5 divides a square. Before we learn a theorem, if 5 divides a square, then it divides a also. 5 divides a square, then it divides a also. Now a can be expressed in the form of 5 into c. So now squaring on both sides, what was it happen? A square is equal to 5 into c whole square, which gives a square is equal to 25 into c square. In the place of a square, you can introduce the value 5 into b square, which means 5 into b square is equal to 25 c square. 5 b square is equal to 25 by 5 into c square. B square is equal to 5 into c square. Since a square is equal to 5 into b square. Once observe, if 5 divides b square like this, if 5 divides b square, it divides 5 also. If you consider, this is a statement 1, this is the statement 2. From statement 1 and 2, we got a comma b have a common factor. Five. Because a is possible, a is divisible by 5, here b is also divisible by 5, which means a and b have a common factor, that is 5. But what you said, a comma b are coprimes, but a comma b are coprimes. Coprime means it doesn't have any common factor, but we got it has a common factor, that is 5. Why this type of different statements are arranged? Because what we are choosing, that is entirely wrong, which is a contradiction. Why this was arranged? Because our assumption is wrong. If our assumption is wrong, means the given statement is correct. What is the given statement? Root 5 is a rational number. Therefore, root 5 is rational number. It is a proof. Once observe what we did here, we are taking root 5 is a rational number. If it is a rational number, it is possible to express in the form of p by q. By cancelling the common factor in between numerator and denominator, we got a coprimes, that is r in p by q is transformed as the simplest form. Those are coprimes, which means it has no common factor. So root 5 is transposed in the form of a by b. It is expressed as a is equal to root 5 into b. On squaring, we got the a square is equal to 5 into b square. If a from this 5 divides a square, then it divides a also. Here a is equal to 5 into c. Squaring on both sides, we got a square is equal to 5 into c square, a square is equal to 25 c square. Already we know a square is equal to 5 into b square. If you enter this in the place of a square, that is 5 b square is equal to 25 c square. B square is equal to 25 by 5 c square. B square is equal to 5 into c square, because 5 table cancels in 25 by 5 times. If 5 divides b square, according to our theorem 1.6, it divides 5 also. From 1 and 2 statements, what we got? A comma b have a common factor, that is 5. But what is the correct one? A comma b are coprimes. Both statements are different, so which is a contradiction, because our assumption what we have taken root 5 is a rational is entirely wrong. Then we have proved that root 5 is a rational number, hence it is the proof. If in your examination same question is asked, but you have to prove root 2 is an irrational, root 2 is an irrational, you can easily write the same procedure. If root 2 is irrational, let us assume root 2 is an irrational. If it is an irrational, it is possible to express in the form of p by q. If it is p by q, by cancelling you got a by b, you got root 2 is equal to, you got a is equal to root 2 into b, you got a square is equal to root 2 into b whole square, you got a square is equal to 2 into b square. From this 2 divides a square, then it divides a also. Then it is possible to express a is equal to 2c. A square is equal to 2c square, 4c square. But you know a square is equal to 2 into b square. 4b square, 2b square is equal to 4c square. B square is equal to 4 by 2. C square. B square is equal to 2c square. If 2 divides b square, then it divides b also. From this 1 comma 2, we got a comma b have a common factor, that is 2. So a comma b are coprimes, which is a contradiction. Our assumption is wrong. Then root 2 is irrational. So any irrational number given, whether it is root 2, root 3, root 4, root 4 not, root 5, root 7, whatever it may be, you can easily prove the same procedure by changing the number. Next one, prove that the following are irrational, in that 6 plus root 2 is an irrational number. In the same type solution, let us assume that 6 plus root 2 is rational. If it is rational, it is possible to write in the form of p by q, where p comma q are integers. P comma q are integers. Try to transpose 2 to that side. 6 is equal to p by q minus root 2. Squaring on both sides, squaring on both sides, what should you get? 6 square is equal to p minus p by q, p by q minus root 2 whole square. 6 square means 36. It is in the form of a minus b whole square. Already you know a minus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. By applying this formula, p by q whole square plus root 2 whole square minus 2, here in the place of a you can write p by q into root 2. So what was happening? 36 is equal to p square by q square, square root cancels, plus 2 minus 2p by q root 2. Once transpose the term which is containing root 2 to left side and transpose 36 to right side, what will we got here? Minus 2 by 2p by q into root 2, if you transpose to left hand side it becomes plus 2p by q root 2. 2p by q root 2 is equal to here 36, if you transpose to that side it becomes minus 36 p square by q square plus 2 minus 36. 2p by q into root 2 is equal to p square by q square minus 34. If you transpose to 2p by q into root 2, 2p by q to that side, it becomes q by 2p. Root 2 is equal to p square by q square minus 34 into q by 2p by 2p. So find the LCM, p square minus 34 q square into q by q square into 2p. Q square cancels, p square minus 34 q square by 2p. Here p comma q comma 2 comma 34 are integers, then root 2 is rational. But what is the actual? But root 2 is irrational. Actually, through this procedure we got root 2 is a rational number because it is expressed in the form of p by q. But actual root 2 is an irrational. Why? Which is a contradiction? Contradiction means both are different statements. Why this contradiction is arised? This contradiction is arised because our assumption is a wrong assumption. That's why we got a different statements, different false statements. So that's why, because our assumption is wrong. If our assumption is wrong, what is correct one? What was the given is correct one. What is the given one? 6 plus root 2 is a rational, irrational. 6 plus root 2, therefore 6 plus root 2 is irrational number. Hence, it is the proof. Once observe, if 6 plus root 2 is a rational number, you are taking, assuming, which is possible to express in the form of p by q. So remember carefully, if both numbers in that that is related by addition, in that you have to choose what the number having root, you have to transpose to right hand side. The number which is not have root, that should always keep in the side of right hand side. This step you have to remember carefully. Then after, follow the procedure, squaring on both sides, you get like this. On simplifying, you get last root 2 is equal to p square minus 34 q square by 2p. Here p, q, 34 all are 2, all are integers. If these all are integers, then root 2 is a rational number. But actually root 2 is a irrational number. Both statements are different. Why this was happened? This is a contradiction because our assumption what we are taken is wrong. So that's why given 6 plus root is an irrational is correct. Hence it is the proof of that 6 plus root a is an irrational number. Prove that the following are irrational, in that 3 plus 2 root 5 is an irrational number. Let us assume, first of all, let us assume 3 plus 2 root 5 is an rational number. If it is the rational number, it is possible to express in the form of p by q. 3 plus 2 root 5 is possible to express in the form of p by q, where p comma q are integers. P comma q are integers. Well, before I said, if the both numbers is related with the symbol plus, means we have to transpose the number which is containing root, and we have to keep the number which is doesn't have root in the right hand, in the left hand side. So then 3 is equal to p by q minus 2 root 5. The same procedure, squaring on both sides. What we got? 3 square is equal to p by q minus 2 root 5 whole square. Already we know a minus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. By uses of this formula, 3 square is equal to 9 p by q whole square plus 2 root 5 whole square minus 2 a in the place of a p by q into 2 root 5. Well, 9 is equal to p square by q square plus 2 root 5 whole square means 2 square means 4. Root 5 whole square means square root cancels, it becomes 5 minus 2 into 2 4 p by q into root 5. So 9 is equal to p square by q square plus 4 5 is 20 minus 4 p by q into root 5. So for transpose the term which is containing a root number to the left hand side and transpose 9 to the right hand side, what would happen? It is a minus number becomes plus and plus number becomes minus. 4 p by q into root 5 is equal to p square by q square plus 20 minus 9. What was happen? So root 5, 4 p by q root 5 is equal to p square by q square plus 11. So keep root 5 here and transpose 4 p by q to that side. Root 5 is equal to p square by q square plus 11 into 4 p by q becomes q by 4 p. Root 5 is equal to conductor LCM. The LCM is q square, it becomes p square plus, here 1 means 1 q square, sir, q square into 11, 11 q square into q by 4 p. Q square cancels, then root 5 is equal to p square plus 11 q square by 4 p q. Clear with that? Here p comma q comma 11 comma r 11 comma 4 are integers. If all are integers, then root 5 is showed as p by q, then root 5 is rational number. But already we know what is that root 5 is an irrational number, but root 5 is irrational number. Both statements are opposing statements, which is a contradiction. Then which is a contradiction, which is a contradiction. Why it was erased? Why this contradiction was erased? Because the statement what you are choosing is a wrong statement, because our assumption is wrong. If our assumption is wrong, what is the correct one? 3 plus root 2 root 5 is an irrational number is correct. Therefore, 3 plus 2 root 5 is irrational number. If it is irrational number, hence 8 is the proof. Hence it is the proof. Once look, 3 plus 2 root 5 is a rational number. We are assuming like that if it is a rational number, it is possible to express in the form of P by Q before like transpose 2 root 5 to right hand side. On squaring we got, and solving and simplifying we got 2 root 5 is equal to P square plus 11 Q square by 4 P into Q. Here P comma Q comma 11 comma 4 are integers. Those are integers. The P by Q form is also a rational number. What is the P by Q form? That is root 5. Then root 5 is a rational number, but root 5 is not a rational number, that is an irrational number. So which is a contradiction. Why this contradiction was arised? Because the statement what you are choose, that is a wrong statement. Then what is the correct statement? What is the given sum? 3 plus 2 root 5 is an irrational number is a correct statement. Hence it is the proof. So now we have to prove that the following are irrational, that is root 3 plus root 5 is an irrational number. So let us assume root 3 plus root 5 is a rational number. If it is a rational number, it is possible to express in the form of P by Q. Then before I said, if a number without root, a number with root, means you have to transpose a number with root to the right hand side. But here both numbers having root, so that's why you take any number. I am transposing root 5 to the that side. Then root 3 is equal to P by Q minus root 5. On squaring both sides we got root 3 whole square is equal to P by Q minus root 5 whole square. It is in the form of A minus B whole square, that is equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB. So that's why root 3 whole square means square root cancels, it becomes 3 is equal to P by Q whole square plus root 5 whole square minus 2AB P by Q into root 5. Then 3 is equal to P square by Q square plus square root cancels 5 minus 2 P by Q into root 5. So transpose the term which is containing root to the left hand side and the number 3 to the right hand side. It becomes, it's a minus term becomes plus term. 2 into P by Q into root 5 is equal to P square by Q square plus 5 minus 3, because plus 3 becomes minus 3. So transpose 2 into P by Q to the that side, what will happen? Let us see. 2 P by Q into root 5 is equal to P square by Q square plus 5 minus 3 becomes 2. Root 5 is equal to P square by Q square plus 2 into 2 P by Q becomes Q by 2 P. So root 5 is equal to, by conducting LCM, P square plus 2 Q square by Q square into q by 2p. Q square cancels. Root 5 is equal to p square plus 2q square by 2 into p into q. 2pq. Here p comma q comma 2 are integers. If these are all integers, the expressed term p by q is a rational number, then root 5 is a rational number. If it is a rational number, actually it is not a irrational number, but root 5 is a irrational number, which is a contradiction. Why this contradiction was arised? Because our assumption is wrong. Then what is the correct one? Root 3 plus root 5 is an irrational number, hence it is the proof. Are you observed? Just I replace the terms what I have to prove. The remaining procedure is same for all the sums what I have explained up to now. Of course, if root 5 plus root 11 is a rational number, proof he asked like this, means the same procedure, same step, same matter you have to follow to prove that is an irrational number. Question is, prove that root p plus root q is an irrational number where p comma q are primes. Solution: what is the given statement? P comma q are primes, and to prove root p plus root q is irrational. So if p comma q are primes is not given, we should follow the procedure what I have explained the before sums. But here p comma q are primes given. If p comma q are primes, then root p comma root q are irrational numbers. If p comma q are primes, then root p comma root q are irrational numbers. Before I explain, we know sum of irrationals are also a irrational. We know that sum of irrationals are also an irrational number. Here root p comma root q are irrationals, their sum is also irrational number. Hence it is the proof. Because given p comma q are primes, if p comma q are primes, then their roots are irrational numbers. Already we know sum of irrationals are also an irrational number. So then root p plus root q is an irrational number. Hence it is the proof. Children, up to now from the exercise 1.4, you all learned about if a rational number is given, how to prove. If a rational number in the reciprocal is given, how to prove. If a number and a rational number addition is given, how to prove. I explain. A number and with the another number and a rational number given, how to prove. I explain. Sum of two rational numbers, how to prove. I explain. So from this all, the important thing is this sum, this type model. These type of model sums are important. Like this, root 5 plus root 11 is an irrational number, prove. Or root 5 plus root 7 is an irrational number, prove. Or root 3 plus root 5 is an irrational number, prove like this. Or 2 plus 3 root 5 is an irrational number, prove. Or 6 plus root 5 is an irrational number, prove like this. Sums are came in the public examinations of previous. So have a focus on exercise 1.4 to get good marks in your public examinations. These all sums are got by through practice only. So practice well and have a great knowledge and have a good marks in your public exam. Thank you to all.